There are a lot of videos out there that really do a really good job at presenting a lot of the different features and how they're created. But one that I haven't been able to find much on was this dessert feature of, wait, no, it's a desert feature. Two S's. You want a double serving. A desert feature. Well, that's much less exciting than dessert features. That's okay. We'll talk about yardangs anyway. Okay, so here is what we have. A yardang is an erosional feature, meaning that it doesn't have to do with transportation or deposition. Mainly, we're going to see these features either as erosional features or depositional features. This is an erosional feature. Now, here's what you're going to have. Out in these areas that are more arid, you're going to have this rock sticking up right here. Sure? Right. Okay. And if we were to see that rock from the top, right, it might be a regular old rock that's sitting there in the middle of the desert. Is it really in the desert? Well, okay, sure. Yeah, we'll do a little greenery there. A little greenery there. Okay, the reason that we see these more in the desert is because in the desert, it's going to be dominated by wind, right? In other areas where you have water, then that makes sense. Now, what happens out there with the wind? Well, the wind is going to be blowing along, and as the wind blows along, it doesn't blow along just with the wind. Sometimes it's going to have small particles of sand. So we have wind and sand that's blowing along, and it's going to be plowing into this rock. And what's going to happen to this poor rock is it's going to start to get sand blasted. If you've ever been to the beach on a really windy day, you know exactly what this poor rock is going through. The rock is going to be sandblasted constantly. And in our deserts, we're going to usually have a dominant direction where the wind is blowing from. And so, as a result, what we're going to start to see, especially with these poor rocks, is that we start to chunk away at the material, especially along the sides of this rock. So, let's look at it from above, right? So, the wind is going to be coming along. It blows, and it's blowing right around this rock. Now, where is the wind going to be moving the fastest past that rock? It's going to be right here along the edges. And so what we're going to start to see is a lot of nicks being pulled out of the side there. And of course, the top of this rock is going to get beat up pretty well as well. What eventually ends up happening is the shape of this rock starts to change. And so instead of being that nice round shape, we actually start to get it shaping like the hull of a boat, right? Or the underside of a boat, because that wind has been rushing by, sandblasting away at that rock. And so what it ends up looking like is our old rock was just sitting there all sandblasted. If we were standing upwind and the wind were blowing right past us, what we would see is this elongated rock that was shaped more something like that sticking out of the ground because the wind was going to be blowing past it and eroding it down. Right? So it's going to be longer, it elongates these rocks, and we call these elongated rocks out there. I don't know who came up with the name, but we call them yardangs. A yardang. Yards? Dang, dang. What happened in the yard? No, because then you'd have two D's. Anyway, we call them yardangs, and they're elongated rocks that we find out in the desert. They are the result of erosion by the wind, sandblasting away at these rocks.